We are going to start learning the halachot of Rosh Hashana. We're continuing, actually. We got up to Siman Tav Kuf Peidal. Okay, before we go on in Siman Tav Kuf Peidal, which is 584, in the previous Siman Tav Kuf Pei Gimel, we have to point out one more important halacha, that when we eat the simanim at night, right, it's very important for people to know, you have to make sure that you have the way it's done is the following. Let's say you take the dates, right? The dates. And you make a bracha, Baruch Ata Hashem, Elokeinu, Melech HaOlam, Borei Pri Haetz. Take a bite on it. Bite a piece. And only afterwards say, Yi Ratzon, and then finish the rest of it. Or you could do it two pieces, as many as you want to eat. I just want to make sure that people don't come under the impression that they have to say the bracha on the fruit, right? And say Yi Ratzon before actually eating it, because that's a hefsek. It's interrupting between the bracha and eating. You're not allowed to do that. Make sure you don't interrupt between the bracha and eating of the fruit. And after you eat the fruit, then you say the Yi Ratzon afterwards. And then you eat another piece afterwards. Okay, that's something very important for people to know. You first make a bracha, you eat, and then you say Yi Ratzon, and then you eat a little bit more. Because as you're eating it, you say, Hashem, please make these things go away from me. Okay? Istaku avenu, itamu avenu, and all the other things. Yes?
So you hear that song, the one that's like in the book, when we follow the book, like the Bukhari book.
Right.
It says like before, each one it says, you hear that song, just you.
Right. First you make a bracha, you eat a little bit, then you say haetz, whatever the bread doesn't cover, whatever the bread doesn't cover. If you do it before Amotzi, if you do before Amotzi, like the way Bukharians are accustomed to do, you make up a kiddush, and then you sit down and you make the seder, you start eating, you make main brachot, which is haetz and adama. It's the two brachot that come up over there, and then you also make shakol and the head of the fish, or on the head of the cabbage. If you do get it, please be careful with these things. When you buy a head of a whole head of lamb, you don't mess around, don't play around, because there has to be a way out to, the kashering process has to be done the right way, the soaking, the salting has to be done the right way. You don't want to come to problems. Go with the head of the fish, and even the head of the fish, when you clean it out, make sure when you open it, you eat, you make sure you have to first, before you cook the whole head, you have to make sure there's no tolaim in it, no worms in it, because if there's a worm in it, the whole thing is talif, just throw it straight in the garbage. Just as long as, don't eat the tail, you could eat more, the closer you get to the front, I think you'll be fine. Just make sure there's no bugs, right? You know, people say, I want to be careful, I want to be the head, right? I want to be the Rosh Hashana, and I'll eat the worms and all the bugs.
What's the problem with saying, first, let's say you said the bracha, I don't know, what we say adama usually?
Lubia or karti,
okay,
whichever one.
Okay, so then next something that's also adama, you don't say adama.
No, we covered that already. We said not to make a bracha twice.
So you just say Yi Ratzon, and you eat the...
Yeah, then you say the Yi Ratzon, and you eat it, sure, of course, okay. Let's proceed, I just all that to make sure is to tell you that you should not make a hefsek between the bracha, the eating, and afterwards say the Yi Ratzon, and continue eating a little bit more. Now, let's go to the next point. He says over here that he brings down that there's a concept of, the Lama points this out, that there's a custom to go during Rosh Hashanah. And between Rosh Hashanah till Rosh Hashanah Abba, we have time to go to say the Tashlich. People go and they throw their Averot away. I just want to clarify one thing to make it clear. Don't get any ideas that you're throwing away only the Averot and you're keeping all the mitzvot. No, it doesn't work that way. When you go to throw away, you're throwing away everything. You are being a newly born baby, starting fresh, starting anew. Which means when you say Tashlich b'mitzvot kol chatotam, right? Hashem takes away all that and throws them away. Rabbeinu Yonah, I believe it's the Geret Shuvah that he brings us down over there. He says when people throw away their averot, they're throwing away all their zchuyot and all their mitzvot too.
So you don't have any merit for them?
You throw everything away. You are starting clear. You clarify. You're clearing everything was there before, huh? It's a great thing to do. It's a great thing. Rabbeinu Yonah brings down. He goes at length explaining the concept that every person should do that. Every year, a person should come to a point of coming to a point of saying, you know what? I want to throw away all my averot and all the mitzvot in all. And you shouldn't say to yourself, no, who am I? After all, I have all the averot. I'm terrible. I'm bad. And I have so many good things that are not fine with me. And the character trait after in the midot. No, you should push yourself to do it. So Atad Yetzer says, oh, this is Yetzer's work. He knows how to get to you. So make sure you go ahead. You do it. Throw away everything. Start fresh. Be smart. So how do you start fresh? So people who have the noodles are cooking the pot, right? You're stirring the noodles, the brain is cooking, and you know that you have to go in one life. Take the Sefer HaMitzvot, take the Sefer Mitzvot HaSeh, Mitzvot Lo HaSeh, take all the Rabbanan, learn through the concepts, learn them all. I'm talking to myself, I have to improve more than all of you. People think that, you know, I'm a tzaddik. No, I have to work on myself. It's a lot to go, a lot. Believe me, when I say a lot, I mean it. Lazy, and I can't stop telling you how much there is. But Baruch Hashem, we all have, you know, as long as we live, we can improve. To myself, as that show, I'll try to improve, get a little bit better this year. But the concept is to throw everything away. Everything. When you throw everything, you start going to throw away your avilot, you're throwing away your mitzvot too. And you're starting pretty much new. No, that's not what we're talking about. That's not what it means. Okay, the next concept is as follows. There's a concept we said that on Rosh Hashanah and Yom Kippurim, we know that every holiday, the way you do tshuva is very simple. Be sorry, say sorry, and don't do it again. Okay, say sorry, be sorry, don't do it again. But you have to learn to improve and to become better. But the idea is when you do tashlich, don't come to the point and say, you know what, very easy. One, two, three. I threw away all my avirot. I kept all the mitzvot. My bank. I just credited myself for another 100 years to be safe and clear to go. No, it doesn't work that way. Let's proceed further. This concept of saying, we know that Yom Tov, Pesach, Sukkot, Shavuot, right? Which is mitzvot, which is a holiday of Torah, we all have to say a halel. Say Halel! But if you look in Rosh Hashanah, Siddur, Yom Kippur, Machzor, you don't find Halel in it. And even the Malachim, they were questioning Ribono Shel Olam, they said, Kosh Baruch Hu, Klal Yisrael, Rosh Hashanah, Kippur, why they're not saying Halel? And Hashem said to the angels, he said, what do you want? Sivrei Chayim and Sivrei Metim Putuchim Levanav, right? It says, Book of Life and a Book of Death. He's written before Hashem, he's making decisions on them, and they are sitting there, they're shaking away. You expect them to say Halel? So this is how, in a way, we get excused and not saying Halel. So that is the reason why we do not say Halel and Rosh Hashanah Yom Kippur. There's a concept with Machloket Ashkenazim Sfaradim, if Rosh Hashanah Yom Kippur falls out on Shabbat, if we do say Avinu Malkeinu or not, we say Avinu Malkeinu. We just take away, we skip all the parts that talk about Avelot. But we say the Avinu Malkeinu, sure we do that. And Yom Kippur we say Avinu Malkeinu also. Okay, but I think that even Ashkenazim say Yom Kippur, they say Avinu Malkeinu too. Another concept is, he brings down over here that that on Rosh Hashanah Kippur we should try our best is, you know, to pass the chatzot tefillah, even right, they say you're not supposed to daven, pray early, you have to extend it as much as you can. They should go up until chatzot till midday for sure. So even those people who play nets, they should stretch it out a little bit more. Doesn't mean you should go ahead and, you know, waste your time. No, sit down and learn. It will be a good thing for you. Another concept he brings down over here, there's a concept of to Kriyat HaTorah is very simple, just follow what the shul does. Then he talks about people who are sitting in jail, also we don't bring the Sefer Torah to them, and we don't do anything special for them. There's a reason for that too. There's another concept is when we have this belief that falls out on Rosh Hashanah, right, or Yom Kippurim, the time to do it is, and Rosh Hashanah talks about, is specifically to do it between Kriyat HaTorah and the Tkiyat HaShofar. Why is that like that? Why do we have to do right between Kriyat Torah and Shofar to do the bleed? There's even a concept, they say that because Milah and Akedah pretty much have the same thing in common. What Akedah Yitzchak accomplished is that we were ready to say, I'm sacrificing right my whole being for Hashem Yitzchak. That's what Yitzchak did. So same thing with the bleed, right? We're taking a baby, we're saying, you know, we're ready to sacrifice the baby also for the sake of Hashem. When we go ahead and we make a bleed, we cut. Now, same. So there's even a concept, they say that of Moher, who does the bleed, he should be the one to blow the shofar. And when he does the mitzitah, when he sucks the blood from the baby, he should make it in a way that the blood should be, in a way, you know, remnants of blood left on his lips, shouldn't wipe himself off and take the shofar and blow the shofar with that. That will be also a zechut for Klal Yisrael to ask for us. I know that there's a lot, there are people that do that, that they go and they say, huh? No EBGB, no, sounds real. Okay, anyhow, that is the reason, because we're not, what we all want is we want to be lechatzot. We want to go ahead and to appease Hashem. The more we do it, the better it is for us. Okay, Adkan, Rabbi Hananiah.